Bill Ruddiman, the early anthropogenic hypothesis, posits that human influence on global climate began not with the Industrial Revolution a couple hundred years ago, but rather with the advent of agriculture thousands of years ago. And that even though we know global populations were very small at those times, we also know increasingly so that humans had a significant impact on clearing the land. And probably fewer people had per capita had a larger impact on land clearance than they do today with more efficient agricultural practices. And so we believe that over time, hundreds, thousands of years, that was a big enough effect to artificially increase the amount of methane and carbon dioxide in the atmosphere and to actually reverse the natural trend for the last several thousands of years, which we would have expected to be downward, actually changed several thousand years ago and became upward. So even though that was long before the advent of industrialization, we think that those early farming practices had a significant impact on global climate, artificially warming it. The strongest support for the hypothesis, I think, in terms of the data, is that if you look at the past many interglacial, warm interglacial periods like we're in now, what always happens is that the concentrations of carbon dioxide and methane from natural processes is highest early in the interglacial, and then it drops over time. And right now we're in one of those dropping periods when the solar radiation during summer in northern high latitudes is waning. And so what should be happening naturally is that we would have lower and lower levels of carbon dioxide and methane, which would produce more and more cooling, beginning of ice sheets. Instead, what we found, not just in the last couple hundred years with industrialization, but even before then, that natural trend changed, and it actually went in the opposite direction. And so the big question is why, and the only obvious difference between the current interglacial and all these six or seven other recent interglacials is the is humans and agriculture. And so people who argue that this is just a natural process, that carbon dioxide, methane levels dropped initially, and then 5 or 6 thousand years ago, they reversed direction and went upward. The problem is, why is this interglacial the only one naturally when that happened? And so our hypothesis is that, therefore, it isn't natural. It actually is because of humans affecting the atmosphere. Basically, the deforestation produces a lot of carbon in the atmosphere, and then the other big effect with methane is rice paddy cultivation, which began in Southeast Asia more or less about 6 or 7 thousand years ago. And there's good new archaeological evidence that shows that there was a rapid increase in the expansion of rice agriculture, and that certainly should have increased the amount of methane released to the atmosphere. And all of our colleagues have been working on this show that right at the time, 5 or 6 thousand years ago, there was a big uptick in this type of agricultural practice, and that certainly should have increased the amount of methane released artificially into the atmosphere, and that coincides very nicely with the ice core records that show that that's when global concentrations of methane did go up, even though they had been going down for a few thousand years before that.